So coming further down, we're going to look at the range of motion of the carpus or the wrist joint. And again, I keep saying this, but when we're treating it, as we're evaluating it, we're actually treating it. And I'm cheating a little bit here by treating it. So the starting point is going to be the carpus in line with the radius here. So the radius and the ulna. And here's the space in between those two right there. His extension should be anywhere from 20 to 50 degrees. Now, the best way to test this is to have the arm completely extended out. And if the dog could be laying prone, that would be even better. So if you had a handler, the dog's guardian is with you, and the dog was laying on its stomach with the arm out, this is a better way of testing this joint. And so here's the joint. And you can see he doesn't have a lot of extension. And then we'll go ahead and extend it out and flex it back. Inflection should be 155 to 160 degrees. These numbers are just averages. They don't mean anything for this animal. These are averages of dogs that are large, small. He happens to be a Labrador. You could go find the numbers for Labrador retrievers, I'm sure. But what we're looking for is, where did the dog start and where does the dog end? So there we're getting much more extension. Now the carpus has another couple of movements, and that's going to be a little bit difficult the way he's laying for you to see, but I'm going to show you. These are called deviations, and so taking the bone this way and taking the bone that way. And so they're not rotations. There's not a lot of rotation happening, but these are deviations. So in a human, which is what this one is, we see, so here's a radial deviation and an ulnar deviation, radial deviation, ulnar deviation, and that's what we're looking for there. Pretty restricted, but this is actually very therapeutic, this range of motion testing. You can tell he's not going anywhere.